Our new topic is multiplication of vectors. Under this topic, we are going to talk about dot product and cross product, as well as the characteristic of dot product and cross product. So let's start with multiplication of vectors. Consider vector P, vector Q, and let O be the origin. Let theta be the angle between vector P and vector Q. Draw a projection on vector P from vector Q. Length OT equals to projection of vector Q on vector P. Length OT equals to Q cos theta. Now magnitude of vector P equals to P. Now we multiply magnitude of P and Q cos theta. We get PQ cos theta. PQ cos theta denoted by P dot Q, vector P dot vector Q, that is equals to PQ cos theta. We had vector P and vector Q, angle between them theta. We had drawn the projection and the value of projection was Q cos theta on vector P. Magnitude of vector P was P. Now we multiply P and multiply Q cos theta. Multiply P and Q cos theta. We get PQ cos theta. This value is denoted by dot P dot Q equals to PQ cos theta. And this is called dot product. Here Q cos theta is nothing but component of vector Q in the direction of vector P. And dot product is also called as a scalar product. Vector P, vector Q, and angle between the two vectors is theta, and this length is OS. This gives the projection of vector P in the direction of vector Q. This is equals to P cos theta. Now again, if we wish to find Q dot P, then magnitude of Q, that is equals to Q, so Q and multiplication of the magnitude of projection. The value of projection, that is P cos theta, equals to QP cos theta. The value of P dot Q we had was the PQ cos theta. And the value of Q dot P is also PQ cos theta. Implies P dot Q and Q dot P. We observe that P dot Q equals to Q dot P. The answer is remaining same. Therefore, we can confirm dot product follows the commutative law of vector multiplication. Thus, we came to know A dot B equals to AB cos theta, and we already know that I cap, J cap, and K cap are unit vectors along x, y, and z directions. Now if I wish to find i dot i, then I already know that the magnitude of I cap is equals to 1. Therefore I dot I equals to 1 multiplied by 1 into cos 0, because angle between vector A to vector A is always equals to zero. If two vectors in the same direction are parallel to each other, we consider angle between them equals to zero, since I belongs to vector along x direction. Therefore, angle between I to I equals to zero. We take here cos zero, that is theta. Theta equals to zero here, and I dot I equals to 1 into 1 into cos zero. That is cos zero equals to 1. So 1 into 1 into 1 equals to 1. So we establish I dot I equals to 1. Of course, the cap is there, and J dot J is also equals to 1, and K dot K is also equals to 1. But if I wish to find I dot J is nothing but vector I cap is along x direction and J cap is along y direction. Angle between them is 90 degrees. That is I dot J. As far as this formula AB cos theta, I can write magnitude of I is 1, magnitude of J is 1, and angle between I and J is 90 degree. And I know that cos 90 equals to 0. Therefore, I confirm I dot J equals to 0. Of course, the cap is there. Similarly, J dot K equals to 0 and K dot I also equals to 0. Cap is always there. I dot J, already we are having 0. Now reverse it. In place of I write J, and in place of J write I. That is I dot J reverses J dot I. That will also equal to 0, because the dot product follows commutative law. A dot B equals to B dot A. A dot B equals to B dot A. Therefore, I dot J equals to J dot I. Similarly, J dot K equals to 0. If you reverse it, K dot J, that will also equal to 0. Let us say K dot I equals to 0. Reverse it, I get I dot K equals to 0. Implies I dot J equals to J dot I equals to J dot K equals to K dot J equals to K dot I equals to I dot K. All these values are equals to 0. Suppose we have vector P equals to Px I cap plus Py J cap plus Pz K cap, and vector Q equals to Qx I cap plus Qy J cap and Qz K cap. If you wish to find P dot Q, then P dot Q equals to Px multiplied by Qx plus Py multiplied by Qy plus Pz multiplied by Qz. Let's prove it now. Now we have the P dot Q. I have written the value of P here, vector P, and I have written the vector Q here. Now I am going to get the dot product of the opening the bracket is same as the we open the algebraic bracket, but instead of multiplication, we write the dot everywhere. We don't write multiplication symbol, we write the dot, because we are doing the dot product. Now how we'll do, just we open the regular bracket, this will multiply to this, and here this come here. Of course, the multiplication is written as a dot, because it is not direct multiplication, it is a dot product. Now I have opened the bracket, and after opening the bracket, I have written in the serial order, and I also written the vector term in the bracket and constant term in first bracket. That is Px, Qx, I dot I, like this, all bracket I have arranged. After this, I made a marking for the similar unit vectors, that is I dot I, j dot j, and k dot k, and on the remaining one I did not do any marking. Now I know that I dot j is equals to 0, j dot k equals to 0, j dot I equals to 0, j dot k equals to 0, k dot I equals to 0, k dot j equals to 0. That now I have written the terms which are not equal to 0, and here is the I dot I equals to 1, and j dot j equals to 1, and k dot k equals to 1. That is px qx plus py qy plus pz qz. This is nothing but the result of vector p dot vector q. Therefore, vector p dot q is equals to px qx plus py qy plus pz into qz. Hence, we have proved it. For an example, if vector p equals to 2i plus 3j plus 4k and vector q equals to 6i plus 2j plus 3k, find vector p dot vector q. We compare vector p with pxi pyj plus pzk and compare vector q with qxi qyj and qzk. After comparing vector p and vector q with respective formula, we got px equals to 2, qx equals to 6, py equals to 3, and qy equals to 2, etc. Then p dot q equals to multiplication px multiplied by qx py qy plus pz qz. After multiplication we get 30, therefore p dot q equals to 30. This is the way we can find out p dot q. Now we will discuss the meaning of vector product with the help of animation. What is vector product? For that we consider two vectors, vector A and vector B. They are present in a same plane and they are acting on a body. They are acting in a system. And when both the vectors are present, we want to get another vector. Another vector is perpendicular to both vector A and vector B. It is also perpendicular to the plane containing vector A and vector B. The vector C is a new vector resulting from vector A and vector B. Vector C equals to vector A cross vector B, in generally we call as a cross product, also called vector product. And let the theta be the smaller angle between them. When we want to find out the vector C, we need to find the unit vector in the direction of vector C. Let unit vector u r in the direction of vector c. So vector c equals to a cross b, and vector c also equals to a b sin theta multiplied by unit vector. Since vector c equals to a cross b and vector c also equals to a b sin theta into unit vector u r, therefore a cross b equals to a b sin theta multiplied by unit vector u r. This is what the definition of vector product. The white color surface is a plane. On this plane, there are the two vectors are present, vector A and vector B. Theta is a smaller angle between them, and 360 minus theta is a larger angle between vector A and vector B. Now our discussion will depend upon rotation of the screw with right hand. Therefore, I got a screw here. The following picture showing you the vector A and vector B along with the screw. I kept the screw perpendicular to the vector A and vector B. It is also perpendicular to the plane containing vector A and vector B. White color surface is the plane in which vector A and vector B are present. This diagram showing you theta is the smaller angle between vector A and vector B, and 360 minus theta is the larger angle between vector A and vector B. as the screw rotates in clockwise direction, as the head of the screw moves from vector B and ends at vector A, it covers an angle theta. During this rotation, screw go inside the plane. Direction of the screw is given by vector B cross vector A. Therefore, vector C equals to vector B cross vector A. The direction of the screw is given by inverted right hand. The thumb is pointing in the downward direction. That is, the screw is going into the plane. Direction of the curl fingers gives the direction in which vector B is moving. That is, vector B is moving towards A is indicated by curl fingers. In following video, head of the screw is moving such that the pointer is moving from vector A to vector B. Now, head of the screw is rotated in anti-clockwise direction. Red marker is moving from vector A to vector B and screw go out of the plane. The direction of the screw is given by vector C equals to vector A cross vector B. The direction of curled finger is from vector A to vector B and thumb is pointing upward, indicating the screw is moving out of the plane. Summary: as the curled fingers move from vector B to vector A, the head of the screw moves clockwise direction and screw moves into the plane. And vector C equals to vector B cross vector A. As the curled fingers move from vector A to vector B, the head of the screw moves in anticlockwise direction and screw moves out of the plane. In this case, vector C is given by vector C equals to vector A cross vector B. Characteristics of vector product. This is our new topic. As the curl fingers move from vector B to vector A, the head of the screw moves in clockwise direction and screw moves into the plane. Under this condition, we get vector C equals to B cross A. Vector B cross vector A. And if the curl fingers move A to B, in that case the head of the screw moves anticlockwise direction and screw moves out of the plane. And vector C given by vector C equals to A cross B. Vector product does not obey commutative law of multiplication, that is, vector A cross vector B not equals to vector B cross vector A. But the magnitude of vector A cross B equals to magnitude of vector B cross vector A. Next characteristic of vector product is I cross J equals to K. J cross K equals to I. K cross I equals to J. And J cross I equals to minus K. And k cross j equals to minus I and I cross k equals to minus j. Suppose we have two vectors, vector p and vector q. Vector p given by pxi plus pyj plus pzk, ijk are unit vectors, and vector q equals to qxi plus qyj plus qzk. Of course, they are all caps. Then p cross q equals to determinant of ijk, px, py, pz, and qx, qy, qz. By finding the determinant, we can find out p cross q. How to find determinant? For that, please visit my another video on determinant. I have provided link in my description box. Suppose vector p and vector q representing adjacent side of parallelogram, then area of the parallelogram is given by determinant of vector p cross vector q. Let's prove it. Let OA be the base and BD be the height of parallelogram, then its area is given by base into height, that is OA multiplied by BD. From triangle ODB, sine theta equals to BD upon OB implies BD equals to OB sine theta. OB nothing but magnitude of vector Q. Magnitude of vector Q equals to Q. Therefore, it is Q sine theta. Now, area of parallelogram OACB equals to base into height, that is base equals to OA, magnitude of vector OA, and height we are already having, that is a Q sine theta. Magnitude of OA is nothing but magnitude of vector P equals to P, therefore PQ sine theta. This is nothing but magnitude of P cross Q. Therefore, area of the triangle, magnitude of P cross Q proved.